And now, The Bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
Oh, yeah. It's The Bonfire.
Crackle, crackle.
We are live on a Monday.
In a different studio. They keep batting us around like a fucking cat bats around a mouse.
Yeah, we really are the fucking forgotten stepchildren of Sirius XM.
The favorite child of the Lord, Joel Osteen, is in our offices right now, blessing the normal bonfire office.
Put his fat Jesus sandals right in our dick holes.
You know what I'm mad about Joel Osteen? It's not that he says he talks to Jesus. It's that he gets to see Deb's hot ass today, and we don't get to.
He's capitalizing on black people religiousness.
You think he is?
It's Black History Month, I can tell, because Jacob's computer has... Google's changed their back image to, I think, Black Obi-Wan Kenobi, which is just
Frederick Douglass.
Oh, Frederick Douglass, the peanut butter guy.
No, wait, yeah?
Maybe? No, it's George Washington Carver.
We started our 50th episode the way we started our first.
Late. several minutes late. We thought we were going live. It once again didn't happen, everyone. It's the 50th show, man.
50th bonfire. Thank you, campers,
half
for being around.
A century, and the way that the campers have grown... in just a short amount of time, the things, the emails that Jacob is sending us of all these beautiful women sending horrible, horribly filthy pictures. I love every bit of it.
People coming out to shows.
People coming out to shows.
Brian, I got to hang out with some campers in Providence this weekend. I got to hang out with Brian and his friends. And, you know, it's cool to hang out. It's always awesome when the campers come out to the live shows.
Yeah, I was in Albany.
Albany!
Albany, yeah, same thing, man. Crackle, crackle, motherfucker, ringing through the halls there, man. It was touching. It's amazing how much, and people really, like, really love it, man.
Yeah.
That really means something to me. And for 50 shows in, man, I'm still having a blast. I mean, you know.
What I've learned in 50 shows.
It's kind of a dumb thing to say, I guess, at 50 shows. Is that it means like we've been here for two decades.
It's 25 weeks.
Hey, man, still love it as much as the first day we did it.
Since the first day we walked in. What I learned from before the show is after 50 episodes, we still know fucking nothing about radio. You and I.
Oh, my God. Merc everyone's facing. Running around here crazy with all kinds of AWS numbers, whatever the fuck that means.
Yeah, you guys are doing ER talk.
Goat Pogo.
I need to get launched on Progo? The 50SWN, and then Jacobs is stewing. His energy was off.
He's like, well, what about the Progo? He was so frazzled.
He was just slamming the call buttons. I felt like, man, I was nervous.
Yeah, well, we started. Here we are. We're here.
Did you see who our first caller is?
50 episodes. I do. Yeah, I do see where our first caller is.
Let's just get to her real quick, because then we can go to the videos we want to watch.
Yeah, we have videos. We have talk about... I have a good Black History talk, I think, about Greece from last night. Go ahead, Penelope.
Hi.
What's up, sister girl?
What did you say?
I said, what's up, sister girl?
That would be great if she flipped out on me for that.
Sorry, I'm driving.
Oh, sorry.
I'm super nervous.
Why?
I've never done this. I don't know.
You've never done what? Drive and talk?
It's pretty difficult, so I get it.
Yeah.
It terrifies
really
me.
Is that what it is? Is that what you're...
Yeah, that's what it
your
is.
Nervousness
yeah.
that you're driving and talking? Should you not be doing that?
No,
a whole turn signal could throw this thing out of whack.
What are you so nervous about? The fact that there's just...
Oh, yeah, it's on my butthole.
Oh! That's right.
Yeah.
Oh, why would you be nervous? Because we saw your butthole. Jacob, can you bring up that butthole, please?
I don't know.
That'd be great. You sound like a doctor that was giving a lecture.
Penelope, hold, please. Jacob, can you bring up that butthole picture, please?
Can we show... Now, that right there
is...
Wow.
Yes.
Looks like a gummy bear is up your butt.
Why are you uncomfortable with that?
Well, I don't know. Well, I don't know.
Can I ask a follow-up question? Were you directly out of the shower when you did that?
Yeah, that was straight out of the shower.
Yeah.
Both times, I think.
Towel on the head.
Oh, wait, these pictures weren't taken for us. These are ones you had in the archives.
These were in the archives.
Oh, I thought you took personal pics for us.
I didn't take a personal one. I just had those, and I wanted to send them in while I was driving.
Oh, that's so cool of you. Wait,
well, thank you.
So you drive during the whole show?
Yeah, I drive for most of the show. I miss, like, the last half. So, like, I missed every, like, thing after I sent the picture.
Oh, so you missed me saying, could you please send more pictures before the show is over?
Yeah, that was pretty much what you missed.
I missed that.
I really pushed that. This is, butt plug. There's anal beads in one of these.
Well, thank you, Penelope.
Penelope, these are fantastic. Are you a single woman?
No, I'm not. I have a boyfriend.
Okay.
But he knows.
He's totally cool.
Well,
I had to ask.
You know, on a we really wanted to start our 50th episode off just by thanking callers like you, you know, that send us pictures of you with butt plugs right out of the shower.
Hey, Penelope's hot.
Yeah, you are. You're very, very hot.
Well, thank you. I needed to hear that because I need attention a lot.
Penelope, how old are you?
I'm 21.
Good for you.
What?
Just good for you. Out there living life.
Yeah, your boyfriend should let you do stuff like this.
You guys are young. How old is he?
What's that?
How old is he?
30.
Oh, what a piece of shit. I like that guy.
Yeah, well, I didn't have a dad.
Oh,
surprise,
got real.
Surprise.
That got real quick.
As you can tell.
Surprise, surprise. No dad, and you have a 30-year-old boyfriend, and you like butt plugs and butt beads.
It's funny how it goes from sensual to psychological real quick.
No, I think she's just giving reasons, man.
I get it.
She's the same friend.
I get it.
Yeah, Penelope,
bad guy.
I think good for you. How long you had this boyfriend for? Since it was creepy?
3 years.
Since okay.
What? Yeah.
So you were 18 and he was 27?
Yes.
That's pretty awesome.
Oh, good for him. Is he a good looking dude?
You were in high school?
Oh, man.
Uh-oh. This is where we start getting in trouble.
Oh, this is fantastic. She was 18, though.
Yeah. Did he just pick you up in like a convertible out front? Just rev his engine?
No.
Babe, I'm ready to go.
Just playing fucking like hits from the 80s, like Billy Idol and shit.
She's like, who is this? He's like, this is Green Day's Dookie. She's like, I'm too young for that.
What's that?
He's not that old.
No, I'm 38. I'm not judging him. I'm proud of this guy.
We're both older than this guy.
Yeah. No, he looks like he's doing fantastic, by the way. He's got you really. But do you guys have an open relationship?
No, we've actually never done anything. I mean, I'm just, like, embarrassed, as you can tell.
Well, I feel bad. You just said you were going to go home and take more pictures for us. Why are you embarrassed?
I don't know. I was, like, an ugly duckling growing up, so...
Well, you are a beautiful swan with things in your butthole now.
You blossomed.
Yeah.
As the butt plug blossoms from a butthole.
Ah, the old haiku of plug haikus.
You have blossomed much like the butt plug.
You have brought great honor.
You I don't know how much more validation I can give you, Penelope, other than saying you're a hot chick. You're doing fantastic here.
And thank you for the pictures.
No problem. Thanks for taking my call.
Of course. And that's why you have a good one, Penelope.
Yeah, you guys too.
Bye, Penelope. We're looking forward to those pictures.
Yeah, okay. Bye.
Right, bye. I feel like if we were like vacuum salesmen, we'd be leaving and you'd be like, just real quick though, if you want to pick it up.
Oh, what? And by the way, we said, you know, you are supposed to lead us away from filth, but you wanted to take that call, and that was the butt plug girl from last week. We did. We got to kick it off right. But while we're on the picture thing, can we thank?
There's so many people to thank for pictures.
I mean, there's a few. First of all, we got to do Heather, who we saw today. Holy shit.
Thank you, Heather.
Holy shit. Thank you, Heather. I mean, wow. Just phenomenal.
Wow.
Yeah. You didn't see these?
No, I was on the train.
Oh, these were great.
Good for you.
Yeah. No, Lou, she's awesome. We have Kayla, who we saw before, who, by the way, I was correct, is a quarter Asian-y.
Good for you. You know what? You're very good at spotting these things.
Well, if you see her, I mean, she looks pretty Asian-y. I'm surprised she's only a quarter Asian, to be quite honest with you. We had a couple, man, just a couple, girl. I'm trying to think of the other one's name. Do we have the audio we said? Do we have that? Jacob?
Yeah.
The audio. One girl. So hot.
It's Jacob's ringtone.
So hot. Soder.
Jacob's like, it's just on my phone now. I just listen to it all the time.
You heard this before, right, Soder? You saw this? The video?
Yeah, of course I did.
I mean, this girl is beautiful, and she is just getting tagged.
We'll come back to the video later in the show.
Yeah.
Tease it, make sure.
But just to thank these people, I mean, really, it's like, I almost put it out. I didn't put it out jokingly. It's never a joke.
Yeah, you don't fuck around about that.
But I do put it out assuming, like, you know, it's probably pretty jokingly. You know what I mean? Like, I don't know how much, you know, real filth we're going to get. And these girls have come through.
Yeah, it's been very impressive. And it shows you the long arm of Sirius Satellite Radio.
Sydney.
And it shows you the dedication of the campers. And it just shows you that with technology, you really can. Look at that.
We have audio on this?
Then we got to move forward. Because as I said, Jay, I'm going to shepherd you away from the...
Buddy, this was not my... I walked in.
Okay.
Hi.
Okay.
You all right?
Okay.
He was so close to thumbing her butthole in this. If I could do play-by-play?
Wow, get it, guy.
She's hot. She has tramp stamp and a between the shoulder blades. So you can go for the shuffleboard shot, too.
Ah, the high score. You know what's always funny is when sex gets like that?
You can go for the 50 on the skee ball on that one.
It just sounds like you're, like, just cupping your hands. Just like...
Yeah, no, he gave her the business.
I was having orgasms. I was happy. I was staying in it. I was in it to win it.
Yeah, you were. Oh, can we see if we can figure out what they're watching on the TV in the back? Play that back just a second, Jacob. Just cut it back a second. Let's see if we can guess what they're watching on TV. Jacob? Here we go.
Back it up again. I think we can do this.
Yeah, we can cut this down. Come on. This is our Zapruder phone.
Back it up more.
Back it up more.
Shut up, Christina.
Hey, call Marcus.
Take your
fire team across the street.
Yeah. Hey, call Marcus. Chicken fire across the street.
I said take the fire squad across the street.
Is that what you're saying?
Yeah. I don't. Is that? I think so. Take the fire. We're breaking this
Let's
down.
Get it. We're going to get it. Because now what we're going to do is we're going to look up those words. You can Google those words.
Hey, Marcus, across the street.
Hey, Marcus, across the street. Is that enough to Google? Someone Google the words Marcus across the street and Jacob, for the love of fuck, back it up again. I want another whip at it.
We're going to get this fucking thing.
If anybody calls, they can hear that better. They think they got that or they know the answer.
If you know the answer of where that, we're trying to find a camper son in a sex video. We're trying to find out what TV
Jacob,
show.
Jacob, you hear we're talking? Back it up.
Hey, call Marcus. Taking fire team across the street.
Yeah, hey, Crow Marcus.
Should we Shazam it?
I mean, that would be great.
Can we? Shazam it?
Can we Shazam it?
Just her moaning?
Yeah.
Some girl, just Shazam just told you, some girl getting pegged in the Midwest somewhere.
Crow Marcus.
By the way, I think we have about 17 calls come and go. I think they keep giving up on us.
Dialogue at the end. I hear it.
There's dialogue?
Yeah, more.
A little more movie dialogue.
Okay, okay.
Or show dialogue.
What the fuck, bro? I never seen them things that small. What the fuck, bro? I never seen them things that small.
We gotta find out what this is.
Oh my god, shut up, lady.
Alright, we got it, lady. Okay.
This guy's got a long thinny. You're putting it on a little bit for him.
Cup sounds.
He's giving me the beef. That's gunt to butthole right there. The bed squeaky. Where was he fucking her? In a prison stall? Can you unzip it?
Hold on.
Okay. Okay. Done. Show's over. He already got the part.
It was good. It was good.
No! You played the drop right when we needed to hear it. Back it up farther. Damn it, Jacob.
All right, let's move. Hey, call Marcus. Taking fire team across the street.
Hey, call Marcus. Are you Googling all that? We have a crack staff here to do that, Soder. You don't have to do it. Ooh. Maybe. This guy says it sounds like Training Day. Mike in New York says it sounds like Training Day. Thanks, Mike.
Oh.
That might be it. I might be watching Training Day.
Hold on. I got to cross-reference something. I got this.
What?
Oh, man, if Mike in New York might have blown it right up.
Yeah, absolutely. Thanks, Mike. Appreciate that.
All right. Excellent, guys. I hope you guys get to the bottom of that.
Yeah, it's a real mystery here. I mean, this girl is getting pegged, and she is hot.
I won't be able to sleep.
And she is taking it deep, and she is taking it hard. Ball slapping. You hear that? This guy's not fat. No, that's not. His balls wrapping underneath and smacking her in the belly. That's the slaps you're hearing. That's how much this guy's giving her the business. If you pull out Training Day over recording, over the airways, Oh, wait, hang on. Mike, we're going to have to let you go. You might be wrong. So all the compliments I just gave to you, take that all back if you're wrong about this. So we have Seth in Texas who says it's Battle Los Angeles. Seth?
It definitely could be. I was talking to your phone answer, and I first thought Battle for Haditha, which is an Iraq war movie, but then I thought it's a little obscure for people to be watching. So maybe Battle Los Angeles.
Oh, maybe Battle Los Angeles.
I'm looking up a Cro-Marcus in that and not finding it.
It's Cro-Marcus? I thought he said Call Marcus.
I'm looking for anything.
Wait a second. Okay, Seth, we're going to let you go. Battle of Los Angeles, it's in the running for possibly being the thing. Steve in Atlanta. Steve.
Chicago Fire on NBC.
It's definitely Chicago Fire? Marcus.
Chicago Fire. Hold on. Chicago Fire. One of the greatest television shows of all time.
Is it definitely Chicago Fire?
Are you talking North Chicago Fire?
Yeah, Chicago Fire on NBC. I'm almost positive.
You're almost positive.
Hold on. Character named Marcus.
Bowden, McCollum, Cruz, Herman.
I don't see a Marcus here at all.
Dawson, Hadley.
Should we take the all right, well, I don't know. It doesn't seem to be the thing.
Halstead.
Thanks for the call, Steve.
Thanks, Steve.
Appreciate it, buddy.
Marcus might be a minor character, you know.
You're a minor character,
it's true,
Jacob.
It's true. It could be. Let's try Leo in Las Vegas.
God, we're gonna get this, campers. We're gonna fucking get this.
It's The Wire. Marcus Lamell from The Wire.
No.
As Yo Call Marcus?
Yo. Wait, you said it's which character?
It's there's a character named Marcus on there, and it's on The Wire.
Are we on The Wire, Jacob, here?
I will be.
I'm on it. I'm on The Wire. What season, though?
Ah, fuck. I don't remember, but I know. I just remember there was a character named Marcus.
I'll be honest with you. We don't take the call, but Conrad, New York, second. Thank you, Conrad. Seconds, Battle Los Angeles.
Can we just get a hold of her and find out if she remembers what they were watching?
Yes, that's what I'm hoping for.
Schneider, Marcus. I'm not finding anything on The Wire, and I remember The Wire.
Marcus. I don't see any Marcus in Battle Los Angeles.
There's a Marcus Lamell in The Wire.
Okay, Marcus Lamell.
Look up the character, Marcus Lamell. Any Marcuses here still? We see anything on here?
I don't see a Marcus on Battle Los Angeles.
All right. This is all... We're not getting any closer here.
We're not getting closer.
Let's hear the clip again.
I thought we were going to break it open.
Play the clip again. I believe we're going to get this.
You think we are?
Yeah. Skip all the deep dicking, Jacob, you perv.
All right, we get it, Jacob. You want to see her get her black...
You like seeing this girl's cornhole while she's getting stretched out by this deep dicking.
I mean, that's pretty descriptive.
They're not good camera people for 60. Oh, well, back it up. Sorry.
All right, let's move. Hey, Cro-Marcus, taking fire team across the street.
Now,
Cro-Marcus and fire.
I'm not hearing Cro-Marcus. I'm saying Call Marcus, and it sounds like the guy who played the main guy. It was his voice.
Taking fire team across the street.
In Battle of Los Angeles?
Yeah. Jake in San Diego, I agree with you. Again, we don't take the call. Thanks for the call. It could be one of the Bad Boys movies, because Marcus is a character in Bad Boys movies. That's, in fact, that was my first guess. I never said out loud. And Andy in Oklahoma thinks he's hearing Colonel Marcus.
Colonel Marcus. Well, Martin Lawrence is Marcus Burnett in Bad Boys.
He is. Let's hear the clip one more time. What's the next lines?
Take your fire squad across the street.
Did you look that up?
Hey, Cro-Marcus, taking fire team across the street.
Yeah. Take your fire team across the street.
I hear take your fried chicken.
That's racist.
I know, that's what I hear, though.
It's take your fire team across the street.
We got it.
We got it? Wait, Merkface just came off the phone like he was on the phone with the fucking president. You think we got it?
Yeah.
Who is it? Battle for Hadithia?
By the way, it is Battle for Hadithia. Hey, Corporal Marcus, take your fire team across the street.
What
play
is
it again? What the fuck is Battle? By the way, they're right.
Kevin in North Carolina. Got it.
Kevin in North Kekalek. And also, Andy in Oklahoma, also give him credit because he said Colonel Marcus. What the fuck is Battle for Hadithia?
An investigation of the massacre of 24 men, women, and children in Hadithia, Iraq.
Shot. What the fuck?
It came out in 2007.
It must have not been that good because this guy just decided to start plowing his chick during it.
Or it just made him super hard.
Colonel Marcus. Is there a character, Colonel Marcus?
Yep. Cap Colonel Marcus, Nathan De La Cruz.
Now, let's hear the clip one more time. The line should be, "Hey, Corporal Marcus, take your fire team across the street."
That's it. We got it. Dude. We did it.
Wow.
What a victory on the 50th episode.
Kevin in North Carolina.
Kevin in North Carolina, you're a champion.
That was awesome. Awesome call, dude.
Keep it going.
That was really, that was some real investigative journalism we did.
You know, you think, and here's what I just want to let the campers know. You think we don't know what we're doing. You think we're just trolling for filth, but really, we're having a fun game.
And this girl is just, I mean, he fucks her almost to sleep.
And she's got her tank top on, which is pretty crusty.
Tank top and bra underneath.
Yeah, that's pretty movie sex.
I've banged a lot of chicks wearing the tank top and bras.
Really?
Now. Oh, yeah.
Well,
absolutely.
Oh, man, she's smoking hot. All right.
Who's
that?
That's her.
No.
No, it's not.
No. Not absolutely me. Not.
But we, all right. You want to take a break and then come back?
Yeah.
And talk about Wu-Tang, what we always want to talk about?
Yeah. Who doesn't like talking about Wu-Tang? You think I'm going to stop you from doing that?
It's The Bonfire.
Crackle, crackle.
And now back to The Bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
Motivational Music Monday on The Bonfire.
We're celebrating.
It's a celebration of the 50th episode of The Bonfire.
Gang here.
The Miley Cyrus with The Climb. I think we played that because of the episode where Jay got super excited thinking she was naked.
She is naked.
She was? That was real?
I wasn't thinking she was naked. She's been naked 30 times.
You've been naked 30 times.
I'll just keep eating this goddamn thing.
They gave us a big cookie.
We got a giant Mrs. Fields cookie. Jacob gave credit to everybody. Everybody seemed to throw credit back to Jacob like we were going to hate this cookie, but, you know, nice to meet you guys.
Guys, you got a room. Did Jacob get this?
When Christine comes here, she's just going to face fuck it like it's a goddamn bobbing for. Like, you don't have to bob for it. Take a piece.
No. It was Jacob's idea.
The what?
And he bought it.
Oh. This really has nothing to do with you two assholes.
Yeah.
That's true. Would you guys even help him?
We said, yeah good idea, Jacob.
Go grab it.
Yeah.
Well,
I should get the cookie cake.
For Jacob, sometimes that is a lot. He just needs a back. Did he go get, where did he go?
He went to try and get Debs.
Try to go get Debbie D. All right. Close this goddamn box. I'm going to keep going. That's good. Oh, I've been first cookie since the year I was born.
You're 77, baby.
Oh, did you hear that fucking gross fat mouth? Fucking chocolatey. It's different when you're a big guy and you go,
no way, man. We're both. That wasn't a big guy noise. That cookie is delicious. Are you guys gonna have any?
Fuck, that's
good. Yeah, have some.
Yeah, well, get some.
Yeah.
God damn it.
I want to watch. We want to watch you eat, Merc Face Andy.
Lou,
eat.
Yeah. Have some fucking cookie cake.
Yeah, get over here, dude. Is that what this is called? A cookie cake?
Yeah.
I'm a giant cookie.
Okay. All right.
See, you should be jumping up and down doing Hava Nagila Hava.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, she was. What a lovely lady.
She was Jew full.
Oh, man.
The opposite of Jew.
Yeah, we got to get this thing out of us. I'm going to fucking eat the shit out of
it. I'm going to keep housing it.
Should we just touch it a little bit more?
Let's wait, though. We have a lot more show. Let's go back for more in a little bit. All right, just fucking dive in there now, dude.
I'll just take a little piece.
You're almost pulling with your knuckles at this point.
Oh,
got to sit that one off a little bit. Beesh. We had some videos we wanted to watch today.
Yeah, I obviously a lot of people don't like the wealthy because you think of them as assholes.
Mm-hmm.
And then this one fucking dude comes out to be just a true asshole. The guy that...
I've only heard about this. I don't know.
So here's what I know about this kid. He is...
Bought Wu-Tang's album from RZA or from the studio?
I think it was an auction.
Why was there an auction for an unreleased album?
Murkface, you gotta look this shit up. So this guy, Martin, go back, get some more cookie. You deserve it. Get some more cookie, buddy. We're going to talk about evil people while you eat cookies. Mm-mm-mm. You want a cookie?
I'll tell you what, I'll be honest with you. Jacob's not here. I would have went without this frosting stuff.
Can I be honest?
Just cookie would have been
I'm so glad you said that.
Yeah.
Because the frosting really is. And it'd break it's Jacob's like, tiny little mouse heart.
I'm so happy he's not in the room right now.
I know,
man.
It's like...
am I right, everyone? The frosting is kind of like...
Yeah.
You just cut him a cookie.
Yeah.
It's too much.
Yeah. Ruins it.
And it's... It's not good frosting.
Can we also say that he's sort of an asshole for not bringing in milk?
Yeah. I don't want
to... You know, I hate to take back all the emotion we shared during the break, but...
He's out of the room, so I feel like this is safe.
Jake,
what's up without the ice cream? There's no ice cream on the side? And it's like
so just
taking ice cream.
A fucking cookie cake that has could be warmer.
Oh, cool. Hey, way to give us a sorry for missing your T-ball game cake.
Hey, really?
This isn't a celebration. This is a slap to the face that Jacob's
made 100 shows. Why don't you bend us over and shove your fist up our ass, Jacob?
Hey, Jacob, you want to take naked pictures of our moms and show it to us? Maybe put that on a cake for 100 for the old hundo.
You want to stage a kidnapping of my daughter or something?
Jacob goes, Dan, I have an idea for a bit.
What are you going to do?
I'm going to take Jay's daughter.
No, Jacob, that's not... Jacob, I don't like that idea.
My daughter's 5 inches taller than Jacob. That's a true story.
She just leans on him with the jab like Lennox Lewis did
There's
Tyson.
A chance. I don't know how many push-ups she could do, but I bet she can give Jacob a run. She's strong. I'm trying to fuck her up still. She's good. Her fucking legs are powerful.
Holy fuck, I'm never leaving the room.
Why? Dude, we won't make you fight Jay's daughter, only Jacob.
No.
And we're only making Jacob fight her just to show.
Nah, look, you could probably beat my daughter up.
Oh, wait, hold on.
How tall are you?
Wait.
6'7".
Is he alone? Yeah. What'd she say?
She'd come in, but she can't do any... She said no funny business. She can't talk F, Mary, kill.
No.
And she can't give...
Give what?
She can't go sex stuff.
Well, we kind of just wanted to ask her about that other
Paige.
Girl.
Yeah. We just want to talk to her about Paige. But, you know.
She just wants it clean.
You got it.
That kind of makes me like Debbie even more.
And I felt bad. Because I think Ben wanted to come in also. So you want to...
Oh, you know okay? What? Bring Ben in because we'll ask him about this golf chick, too.
Fair enough. He wrote, by the way, Ben just wrote an article on her, so.
On Paige Spivak?
Yeah. And there's photos.
Yeah, get him in here.
All right.
Get him in here. I mean, you guys, listen, I know we're sick of the golf channel too, but this is going to be the conclusion on our 50th episode. And we've got cookie cake.
I won't bet on that.
With unnecessary.
Oh my God,
frosting.
I can't find one piece without this goddamn frosting
dude,
on it.
I've been finding it. You got to pick your spots, dude. And then we'll watch this fucking evil asshole who made a shit talking video to. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you're right. There's so much fucking frosting.
There's so much frosting.
It's just goddamn frosting.
Why don't we play this game? I'm ready to punch this box of cookie.
You're going to hammer fist it?
No, I'm going to take a napkin and just swipe it over the top of the whole smudge everything out that he wrote.
Oh, look at that.
No, it's frosting all over it.
No, it's not. Ah, damn it!
What? You can't do it. You want to play a new game? Let's have callers come in and try to find a piece of this cookie. Doesn't have some goddamn frosting. Why do you pick so many words?
Happy 50th to the bonfire with Big J.
It's so many words.
You could have just said bonfire. Happy 50th, bonfire.
Jacob, we're kidding, bud. I mean, we're half kidding. I mean, we are kidding. But, you know.
I love you, Jacob. I didn't want to do this to you, but...
Yeah, well, neither of us wanted to do it to you. And the thought is amazing. And the cookie is delicious. But you wrote a small fucking paragraph on this goddamn cookie cake. And it's all in not delicious frosting.
Real quick, you watched Grease last night?
Yeah. Don't say real quick.
Well, I'm thinking of something we got to talk about until Ben and...
I'll talk about that till the fucking... till 8 p.m., my friend.
What, did you watch the whole thing?
I watched the whole thing. You're going to say I loved it. I didn't love it. In fact, I thought some of the casting sucked, but I got... You watched it, Lou?
Yeah, I hated
whole thing?
It. You hated it. I hated Zuko.
I didn't like Zuko. There
they come. I just saw a bunch of orange go right by.
The Kaniki, I could have... I wouldn't even have recognized it.
There
seen the scene.
Our neighbors from across the hall have came in to the bonfire.
Our family, our radio brethren.
How are you?
Ben and Debbie.
Now down the hall.
And we have this...
Yeah, we get displaced a lot. They give us no respect here.
Yeah, they just bounce us around like foster kids. But we get it.
If you guys want, it's our 50th show. We have cookie cake.
We have cookie cake if you guys want some.
Hey, congratulations.
Thank you so much. Thank you, guys.
It's awesome.
Well, I know you guys
have more than 50 shows, and I've got nothing.
Well, that's because you got to surround yourself with people that appreciate you. Jacob appreciates us.
Jacob appreciates us.
He went and got us a cookie cake with the most frosting ever.
He knows how to treat men like men. Yeah. And that's what I say. Debbie, we're not going to talk to you about any filthy stuff. We always Shanghai you and ask you all kinds of filthy things and put you
not today, not on the 50th episode.
Not today. Now we're asking you guys to play wing people to us.
Yeah.
We are, now that we're very interested in golf, you turned it everything.
Our passion.
Are
our
you
passion.
Watching the LPGA now?
Absolutely.
Have, look at me growing the game.
I love it.
We have dove in head first, and our heads landed right in the sweet, sweet bosom of Paige. How do you say this name?
Spirinac.
Yeah.
Spirinac.
I like that you already know where we're going.
Yeah.
Which I understand Ben's got an article about.
You're still my number one.
I did a photo shoot with her 2 weeks ago for Golf Digest.
You took the photos?
No.
Oh, you said you did a photo shoot.
I did a photo shoot. I was on site with her doing a photo shoot. Actually, it was a video shoot where she was doing exercises that I taught and I voiced over while she did them.
Oh, wow. Good choice. Did you pick her to be the...
No, I did not. I just...
Was that Golf Digest?
Golf Digest.
That was just lucky that she was the one they sent over?
Yeah, I guess so.
That girl is something else. She really... Jacob... Still, Debbie's number one. Jacob's eyes.
Debbie's still my number one.
You're always number one.
I'm not a turncoat like Jay.
No, not at all.
Thank you.
Stop it. Turncoat? Are you kidding me? Who said go get
what
Debbie?
What era is that from?
I don't know.
A turncoat?
I'm a time traveler.
It's like the Revolutionary War in here.
The Revolutionary War.
Are you talking about Inspector Dan Soder?
Yeah. I almost solved the Jack the Ripper case.
I got turncoat and shoot him.
He's murdering ladies of the evening.
I'm sorry that I've traveled in time to warn you about Jack the Ripper.
When you do the sport of, because this girl, they're definitely, someone's coming to this girl to do some Playboy-esque something at some point, that paper magazine or something. Is she the type that's going to do that, you think?
No, I think that, you know, she's actually trying to play professional golf. She's going to play on what's called the Symmetra Tour, which is like the tour below the big tour.
Minor league.
For women. Yeah, minor league kind of tour. I mean, you get paid, you make money, but, you know, and certainly not the big paycheck.
That's crazy, though, that we've already heard. That girl's so beautiful that we've heard of her.
More than most.
And she's not in the LPGA tour.
And give us the U.S. Open winning her last year on the LPGA tour.
Oh, geez. Injie Chun, maybe? I was there.
Wow. You don't even know who won.
Would you?
So the point is, these guys have never heard of her.
If you...
But they know Paige Spirinac.
Well, I hear an Asian name, so I'm in.
Deb versus Paige, who wins round of 18 at TPC Sawgrass.
Oh, my... Well, first of all, Sawgrass is super tough. Second of all, she's much younger than I am, so we did not play junior golf, college golf together, so I don't know the type of player she is.
Right here, right now, I take Debbie.
Thanks, partner. Ah.
Soder just hit on you with stuff he learned by playing Tiger Woods PGA on a video game. I guarantee
Sawgrass?
It.
Sawgrass?
That's 100% true.
I guarantee it.
I played Golden Tee at the bar the other night.
Yeah. This son of a bitch. Did you see what he just did?
I was like,
what the fuck is Soder talking about?
Sawgrass is a really tough course.
Yeah, we all played it.
I played it with Fuzzy Zoller and Fred Couples years ago.
I hit the island green.
Yeah. That's right. I was in the berm.
Yeah,
I was deep in the shrub.
I want a couple dinners off some roommates playing that course.
Ben, you teach, you do all of the exercise work, training for golfers, right? Yeah. Not all of it, obviously, but I mean, that's what you
do. A bunch of players. I do it for, you know, like I said, advising for stuff for Golf Digest, a lot of different places.
Do you own a gym? Are you a single dude? You're a married guy.
No, I'm a married guy.
Oh, it's the worst.
I do own
just training gym. Hot golf girls, hanging out with Debbie D all the time. Although you're both married, so you both got plenty to lose. Just keep that in mind.
Now we're getting speaking marriage advice from this guy over here.
That's no. I was saying you both got plenty to lose, so if you do anything weird with each other, just keep in mind, both of you shut your mouths. Don't fuck everyone's life up, is all I'm saying. Just keep it at work.
Work it
out in the janitor's closet.
Yeah.
I hear ya.
Jay gives advice. Very direct advice.
Yes. You know, you always want advice from a guy wearing knuckle gloves and a wallet chain. I figure in the golf world, that's got to be a go-to, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Those could be misdiagnosed as weightlifting gloves.
You're like
misdiagnosed fingers indeed. Cut off.
You're their relationships bagger Vance.
That's right. I am.
Giving him all the great advice.
Now you listen up. That was good Black History Month reference. Now y'all listen up. If
and
y'all
going
to get down.
Yeah.
We tied it all together right there.
So you guys don't want any of our cookie cake?
No, but thank you.
Why are you mad at me?
I'm not mad at you, dude.
You coming to Dan's house and you shit in his picnic and don't eat a piece of his cookie cake?
It's cool.
Do you want me to have these?
Of course he wants you to have a piece.
Oh, no, it's okay
I
now.
I went to the M&M store, so I have some M&Ms.
You're saving it for M&Ms?
Dude, we have 2 hours.
You will take, please take one little piece of this. Ben, no.
You guys haven't even done a very good job yourselves, to be honest.
Well, I mean, there's two of us, and now there's four of us have taken a shot at it.
Yeah, there's four of you, and you guys have not even come close to even half.
Do you guys do, like, what are you doing for your 50th? Like, any special guests?
Our special guests?
Our
first call was a girl sent us pictures of her with a butt plug in. That's how we started.
That's a good special.
Okay.
That's special.
And now we're on the cookie cake.
It was special. We moved on the cookie cake. It's a disjointed show, if you will.
It's a real start fast, pull back, start fast.
Was that what she was doing, or that was the show?
Yeah.
I can give you a recap of the whole thing. Our first half hour, a fan sent us in a video of her having sex with her boyfriend from a while back. Very graphic.
Very loud.
Very loud. In the background, faintly, you could hear... TV is on. And a half hour using callers, using the internet, all this technology around us, we figured out what she was watching. And no one even heard of it before. It's called The Battle for Hibethia.
Hibethia, yeah.
The Battle for Hibethia.
It was made in 2009.
And we're not being a good commercial for it, because it was apparently boring enough that this couple decided to fucking make a video during it. But still, they sent it. Are your guys' fans doing stuff like that at all?
Yeah.
No.
They're not that engaged?
No.
We must keep them so entertained during the show that they're focused on us.
It's possible. Well, you know, thank you guys.
You're welcome.
Thank you guys for coming and hanging out with us on our 50th.
Thank you for being a part of the Bonfire.
Such a big part of the show.
Oh, congratulations, guys.
We love seeing you guys come in. Thank you so much, Ben.
Awesome. Enjoy your cookie.
I mean, you got to get some of this cookie, Ben. It's got orange on it, Ben.
It's got orange.
I'll have a little piece
if
of
you
orange.
Spill it, if we threw this cake at you, no one would tell.
No, yeah, it'd be great.
Just blend it, and I could just lick my sleeve all day long. Right. No one would even know.
Deb, you're still my number one. I don't care what they say about Paige.
No, yeah, I heard this Paige girl's a raging whore. That's the rumor I'm spreading.
Not like you. Don't do that.
Not like you. Beautiful woman.
Not like me.
Not like you. You're a good person.
Thanks, man.
You guys have a great show tonight.
All right.
Plug your show.
Gotta prepare.
Yeah, Golfer's Edge, Sirius XM PGA Tour Radio, Sirius 208 XM 92, Monday nights 7 to 9.
Seven nights, so listen to their show 8 to 9 when we're done.
Exactly.
8 to 9, you swing over.
You can get the simulcast right here on Bonfire as they play it right through the show.
Yeah.
That is true.
Sometimes we pipe in your show when we want to take a quick 5.
Golf, a good day.
Or listen to the golf show.
Yeah.
Congratulations, right, you guys.
Thank you guys. Have a good show.
Good luck with your research.
That's Ben and Debbie from Golfer's Edge. Yeah. She has to go get Zen first.
Yeah.
Thanks, Debbie.
Bye, you guys.
Bye.
Soder, you're so full of shit.
Dude, did you see...
You would step on her face with golf cleats to fucking fuck that page.
No way, man. I'm dead first.
Yeah, right you are.
All day.
Why, because you actually knocked one out to her already?
Yep. I'm committed.
You haven't knocked me out to that page chick?
Nope.
You can't, because it's G-rated pictures. So you say you can jerk to G-rated pictures?
I can absolutely jerk to G-rated
pictures. But not that pictures. Page girl. Motherfucker, put this cake away.
It's too good.
So good.
It is.
I'm sinking into it.
You know what I do is I put my hand under the box like this because it don't feel as bad.
So then God can't see my sins.
They can't see me being a piggy.
We do. You know what? I think we're gonna listen. Watch it. What is this now?
What is that?
I'm sorry, Paige.
Paige just sent that
new photos. Yeah.
Wait, not Paige.
Why are you saying Paige?
Penelope?
Sorry.
Is it Penelope?
Penelope.
Oh. Show that again. Did she just take that? Is she taking these right now, fresh? We have to find out.
Just came in.
Hot off the press.
She's not listening probably now because she's home. I guess she doesn't have a smartphone where she can download her Sirius into that. What a dummy.
Hey, I think she's great.
She's fantastic. But
by the way, can I just say great?
Finger in her butthole, her personality on the phone does not lend itself to me thinking she's going to send us a picture of her fingering her own asshole. And that is literally one of the most favorite pictures I've ever gotten in my life.
Great job calling me out on the Tiger Woods.
Oh, dude, how great was that? I just saw that come on TPC Sawgrass. Like, this fucker's throwing horseshit Tiger Woods ropes. And her blowing her dude, man. That's fucking great. We should take Nicholas's call because we put him off last week, told him to call back with his virginity story.
Yeah.
And it was... And we should take this, and then when we come back from the next commercial, we'll watch the video.
Hold on, what about Isaiah though?
Yeah, okay, all right, Isaiah, he's gonna give a shit. Isaiah, what's up, buddy? Isaiah, Isaiah, where are you?
He's watching Battle of Hybethia.
He's like, hello? Hey, what's up, Isaiah?
What's up, Isaiah? Hey, what's up, man? My bad. I had my headphones in. Wasn't going through, but what's going on, Dan? What's up, Big J?
What's up, Isaiah?
You said we played it too safe with Deb?
No, I think, like, Soder, usually, man, you're like the go-to guy, man. Like, you usually give it up. But since Debbie didn't want to hear nothing about any sex or anything like that,
yeah.
It seems like Big J didn't give a fuck. He just shot his gun, man. And Soder, I could tell you were kind of
pissy
about saying anything as far as sex goes or whatever, but...
I wanted to keep the fight alive.
Soder plays by the rules.
You kept it alive, but...
I did.
Something titillating about Debbie, man, and you guys are pulling it out slowly but surely.
No.
I'll tell you this, and let me tell you something, Isaiah.
We're going to Bukkake her before 2017.
Because you can't see in the studio, but she... She like when Jay talks about sex, she's really cool about it. And when I bring it up, she's like, she doesn't have any time for it.
She's disappointed, so she expects more from him. You see, I set in relationships, Isaiah, I set the bar way low early with like my class and crass verbiage.
Yeah. Well, I'm just hoping. Right.
Soder's got a pleasant. Like boy face.
I do. And my hopes being that if Deb's marriage ever crashes and then we're like in the, you know, like the snack area together.
Right. She's going to come
to
you.
It was like a good cop. It was like good cop, bad cop.
Exactly. Yeah. Dan's going to take her on like a coffee date if she ever breaks up with her husband. And I'm just going to be the guy who like just drill fucks her like in a fucking broom closet somewhere.
Yeah.
Something about that guy, Ben, like, he slides little subliminal messages in, like he tried to say something about your gloves looking like workout gloves.
And, yeah, it's not subliminal.
I take relationship advice from this guy, and, you know, so...
Yeah, You know what I do?
I self-deprecate around Ben a little bit, so I take the power away from him, so he sees that I don't take it that seriously, but he... Definitely, yeah. He is not our fan.
Yeah,
not the high school coach out of him.
Yeah, exactly. That's what we got to do. But Isaiah, thank you for calling us on our shit because you're absolutely correct.
Thanks, you guys. Thanks for taking my call.
You're a good one, dude. And then now,
before we go to break, Penelope, Penelope back on.
What about Nicholas, though?
We're going to hear Nicholas's story before break, but I'm saying, like, but just real quick.
All right.
Penelope.
Hi.
Hey. Love the pictures.
Now, you say that's your finger in your butt. I know it's your finger in your butt. My question is, did you just take that picture now?
I didn't. I'm still driving. I have the longest commute in the whole world.
Oh, I don't know why. By the way, the picture is fantastic. That said, it means so much to me for the pictures to be for us. Like,
okay,
so,
as soon as I get home, I'm...
Yeah, listen. I believe you.
4 hours at home.
Listen, I believe you. I don't think you're not going to do it. I'm just letting you know. That's what I love. But thank you again for these pictures. You're doing the Lord's work. Or maybe the devil's work. And maybe that's why we kicked out by Joel Osteen today.
I have to bless this studio.
All right, Penelope. Enjoy your very lubed up car ride home with excitement so you can go home and take pictures for us. Yeah, I get him worked up, Soder.
You do. You really banging the stick on the cage.
Me and Soder working on your earlobes like nips. Yeah.
Thank you.
You got it, Penelope. We'll talk to you soon. She's great.
She is. You know what? She's just a real.
And that's just me and you have totally different feelings about that, right? Like that picture, you're not grossed out by it in any way. You're a man. But that's not.
No.
Like, I love that picture.
The blow picture's awesome.
Blow picture's great.
Yeah.
Sure, jamming a finger up her own asshole does not turn you on at all.
No. Is that weird?
Yeah.
Is that weird? Am I weird, guys?
No, I'm probably weird.
No, I just think we're just...
No, Lou thinks I'm weird.
No, I enjoy it. I enjoy the finger in the asshole.
Like, the crazy filth of that, right? Like, isn't that awesome?
I think it's awesome, but it doesn't necessarily, like, get me like, yeah.
Oh, see, that gets me way more yeah than, like, a girl standing there, like, in, like, lingerie where you can, like, see her nipples through it or something
that. That's pretty nice, though.
No, I know, as I said, I know
pretty,
you like
It's pretty classy.
I am all, like...
I don't
like,
want to.
Yeah, Leslie sends us shit all the time. Leslie just takes loads on the eyes and the chin. She's fantastic.
Oh wow!
Leslie goes big. You met Leslie. I've met Leslie. She does not fuck around.
Dude, it's so funny watching the studio behind us.
just see these videos of just our listeners throwing just fingers
chugging,
their butt.
Just chugging Wang. It's crazy.
Because
the one thing that you cannot compete with is Black Dawn.
And she's right. Leslie, also, shout out to Leslie, who, and she sends stuff every week. She is gangster. We owe it to Nicholas right here to get the story. Nicholas, our friend.
How's it going, guys?
North Cackalack, how you doing, man? You What's called up, back. You did everything you were supposed to do. We are going to hear to listen to your story, my friend.
Thanks a lot, guys. I appreciate it. Real quick, I just got to say, man, you two together, you're the shit. You guys got something special going on.
Thanks, buddy.
I actually called in a couple weeks ago, a little too high, suggesting a sports show or something like that. And I think what that stems from is I was working night shift and wasn't able to catch you guys live or anything like that. So I was going to YouTube to watch your audio or listen to your audio on YouTube. And I guess I was just a little disappointed that, you know, I wasn't finding a live shot show or something like that.
Yeah, we got to do, you know what? That was a good idea, though, about giving some video elements to the show. Kind of let people watch.
Yeah. Yeah, I actually see us doing the show.
Yeah. So we're going to take into account.
We got some things happening, man. There's some stuff shaking up over
Jay's
here.
Jay's wheeling and dealing on the phones,
oh,
baby.
Buddy, I am wheeling and dealing on the phones.
He's taking conference calls.
I had a good hour 20 with Comedy Central the other day. So we're
crossing T's and dotting I's.
We got ideas, man. We got ideas, things are going to be happening. We're going to try to get a video element to the show. That's one of the things that we talked about. So, yeah, we're definitely...
we talked about getting biker vests
for
us and all our campers.
The show's only going to grow.
Full rockers.
Now, make our dicks grow with your hot-ass virginity story.
Another Bonfire Tales of Ribaldry.
All right, so let me set the scene. It's 2006. I'm a junior in high school.
All right, George W. Bush is still in office.
Yeah, that's right.
Number one song at the time was Ciara. No.
my high school is... A lot less conservative than my upbringing. So me being 17 years old, still holding the V card, I'm starting to feel the pressure. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, you're getting that peer pressure.
Yeah, so I'm like, I got to get rid of this thing.
Now, were you looking to unload it anywhere, or were you just like, did you have a specific target in mind?
Pussy.
You know,
a vagina.
I think I had my opportunities with, you know, some patties, but at that point in time, I guess I still have some shred of pride left. I don't know.
at that time, you've lost it since.
Yeah, I like that you've cast away all of your pride.
Yeah, it's gone. So I'm in a class with it's a theater class with a girl who's a senior. And she has a reputation about her, but we're getting along. I'm making her giggle. I'm making her laugh. I'm doing my thing.
And how excited are you getting knowing that you're gaining ground on this lady?
Beyond words, buddy. I mean,
you're like, this is so awesome. I'm working her. Like, you feel like a fucking car salesman about to unload a Lexus. You're like, and I also mentioned this has got air-conditioned seats.
She's like, wow, air-conditioned seats?
Oh.
I'm listening.
He's funny.
You know what? Car salesman is a great analogy because it was all predicated on lies. I mean...
What did you tell her? Did you tell her that you used to fight in underground karate tournaments?
No, I'm saying stuff like, yeah, I can drink with you. You can't out-drink me. And I'm telling you, man.
Were you a dork? Like, did you not drink at all?
Not really. I mean, I might, like, sip on someone's liquor from their parents' cabinet over at their house or anything. But I don't know what the fuck I was
Nicholas,
doing.
Hold on. I don't mean to interrupt your story, but one time in high school, I took an empty bottle of Bacardi and I filled it up with water. And we convinced the sophomore girl that I was going to chug an entire bottle of Bacardi. And I drank it, and then it disturbed her so much that she threw up.
Really?
Yeah.
I thought you were going to say, again, this is the difference in us totally. In my mouth, you're going to say, if I pound this whole bottle of Bacardi, you'll get naked in front of all of us. Yeah. And then you did it, and she had to do it. You're like, no, she was so weirded out. Yeah. We all high five. We had a good laugh.
Yeah, I thought it was a good little ruse. So, Nicholas, so you're lying to this girl to get laid.
Right. So she comes to pick me over at my friend's house I'm staying the night with, and we go over to her place. She's got a fifth of Jack Daniels. I'm like, yeah, I'm going to drink so much more than you. We split the bottle. I'm in way over my head.
Dude, a fifth? You basically drank, yeah. You're drinking a half a bottle of Jack, and you don't drink a lot. You are fucked.
Yeah, that's three sheets.
My friends had a little bit more experience with this than I do. So like, you got to eat a lot. You got to eat a lot to better help this scenario. Because you told me what you had, so I'm just stuffing my face with ramen noodles. I think I had 2 packs of this stuff. And, you know, it might have served well for a little bit, but we get to hanging out in her room. I'm making her laugh. I'm like, okay, we're going to dance. I've got her semi-ballroom dancing through her messy room. And I go,
I've done what, dance. You're bald? I've done the dance.
Wait, you guys are, like, seriously, like, dance with a girl?
But, like, no, it's, like, playful.
Yeah. Oh, joking. Yeah.
I've done, like, let's dance.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a good way of, like, twirling them, and they're like, this guy's silly.
Yeah, just playful in a hotel room or something. Yeah.
May I have this dance? we're in a La Quinta Inn off a dangerous highway.
Oh, yeah. Being in South Jersey, I've pulled the old let's dance.
Hey, this whole place is our palace. So what? It's a roadside motel, but I'm paying only $13 for the hour.
My lady. Wow, you've got moves. Huh? I wonder if you have those same moves in the boudoir.
If you don't mind me, I'm going to lay down this shower curtain on the bed. I like my freaks.
Well done. I've got a 6-day load built up. And I'm ready to hose you down.
So you're dancing with her, Nicholas. Are you dipping her?
That's the thing, man. I went for the dip, and that was a mistake. I dropped her.
And your $1 million?
Did she give you the full trust? Did she give you the full trust dip, or she was like, he got me?
I think she was a little out of her mind to be thinking logically like that, but I went for the dip, and I dropped her straight on a little mini steel trash can.
What did you eat? What, you $1 million babied her? She's just going to be a quadriplegic now?
Sort of foaming at the mouth right away.
He's like, no, 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 no.
Instead of doing the Apollo Creed twitch.
No! Baby, no!
If she dies, she dies.
Yeah. Wait, but I can still lose my virginity before you die, right? She's like, you have 1 minute. You're so cold. Come. Quick.
He's fucking. She's like, I think I see my Nana.
Yeah, I'm going to the light. So after you gave her an ECW move. After you gave her an ECW move.
You guys wanted, huh? You guys wanted it out there?
He's gonna do it. Nicholas is gonna do it.
He's gonna give her
the trash can.
You guys want it out there? She's going up for it.
She's had enough.
I'll say when she's had enough, man.
I think she's had enough. So what happened after she dropped? Besides you getting all sensual.
Her eyes pop wide open like, you know, oh my God, tell me how bad it is. Is there any blood? What's going on? And I'm equally freaked out. So I pick her up, I carry her to her bed, and in the back of my mind, I'm thinking, is it this way this progresses from? But, you know, we both just kind of roll off into a drunken sleep, and I wake up to find all the ramen that I've eaten.
She shouldn't have went to sleep, by the way.
Yeah, she wakes up not knowing who she is.
She shouldn't have went to sleep. She had a concussion.
She wakes up, she's like, who are you?
One of her eyes was googly like that Adam Sandler buddy.
So, wait, you guys fall asleep?
Yeah, I'm not as bad of a guy as I'd like to be.
No, but you're in the Dan Soder camp. We're okay here. We're all good guys.
Me? I went 69 style and skull fucked that gash. Yeah.
But you know what? When you're Dan Soder, you go get a nice cold glass of water for the side of the bed and make sure she's all tucked in.
Yeah. And maybe a nightcap.
Maybe put her hair behind her ear.
So funny. You know what's hilarious? I'm waiting for when, like, the show gets to a point where, like, women that I've hooked up with before, like, start calling in.
Ooh.
To tell you that just like
you're the nicest guy in the world,
just like how like non-aggressive I am. Yeah. We talked about that on the show though too, where the girl really has to lay it out. Like I want to, when it comes to, here's the thing. Once I'm confident,
yeah,
third, fourth time we fucked, I'm gonna try to like. That's when I'm gonna start already trying to bring in weird stuff.
Yeah,
like you know, like anal stuff at all, or like beads and shit like that. That's why I said. That's why I like Penelope so much. She swings for the fences on those pictures
every time, but you know what? She doesn't seem to strike out a lot.
She does not with me. But she's batting a foul.
Nicholas is almost there. So you lay her down on her bed, you guys pass out drunk,
Right, and I'm probably worse off than she is, even though I haven't hit my head on anything.
Were you like, hold my hair, hold my hair?
Well, I don't remember anything other than just passing out on the bed and waking up to find all the ramen that I've eaten strung all over her walls, on her bed, mixed.
You puked it all up. You puked the whole thing up.
Everything.
Oh, and ramen.
I'm just like, oh, that's not me. That must have been you.
Oh, that's like this silly string of food.
Oh, ramen.
I know. It just looks like a and clown's
comes,
coming out.
It comes out exactly like how it goes in, too. Yeah. So you just see it, and like, but you just know how gross it is because it just
like burnt, wet, hot
it
noodles.
It just lived in your stomach for a bit.
Oh, it's got all stomach juice, au jus on it.
Is this a virginity story? Like, seems like you never got your...
I'll tell you this. If this chick fucks you, she is a champ.
Oh, you know what's funny? In technicality, it does say it's a virginity story, not losing your virginity story. Yeah.
So you dust a room with top ramen baked right in your stomach. Then what happened?
Well, you know, it was a pretty disappointing morning. Struck out that evening. Came clean about not really being able to drink a whole lot. And she said, you know what? I know that you're a virgin. We're gonna get this shit straightened out.
Wait, so I like that she acted later, like it was. I like that she like acted like it was paperwork on a small loan.
How old is she?
She was a year older than me, and I'm telling you, this girl was bad, but good girl nonetheless. But she knew what she was doing.
Dude, that's hilarious. She's like, listen,
I think we're gonna straighten this out.
I'm gonna go in the back, talk to my manager. We're gonna get this straightened out. You threw up ramen all over me.
The girl I lost my virginity to basically did like a "I'm going to show you." You know what I mean? Like, I'm gonna
come on.
Sort of. We ended up weirdly getting emotionally attached. It was bizarre, but it started off very, like, clinical. There were some sentences said in that hotel room that you'd just be like, that's hilarious.
Like?
Sometimes, girls, like, when you go down there and lick it with your tongue. Like, shit like that. And I'm like, oh. Yeah, by the way, I'd watch so much porn, but I just, but, you know.
Yeah, I like that she was.
You don't want to be like, all right, I know what to do. I'm just going to start munching on this thing. She was like, I was seducing you like you had a
brain injury.
Yeah, but that's what, like, I told you.
Big boys sometimes put their mouth on there, on down where I make a sissy.
When two people like each other.
Do you want to put your kissy on my sissy?
What does David tell us? They put your sissy stick in my bad place.
Wait, but we got to take a break, but we got to finish this story.
Yes, sorry.
Nicholas.
Right, to wrap it up, very similar in that regard. 2 days later, I go over to her place, and she's telling me what to do, but there's no beating around the bush. It's like, all right, shove your fucking head down there, and she's pulling on the back of my head, and I'm just like, oh God, given everything I've got into this thing, I'm trying to fit my head into her vagina.
Which I did.
Which I pulled off.
Oh no.
Hello?
Right, so she had word around the school was, you know, she'd been around with a lot of guys, some of them black, and there might have been evidence. I'm not a doctor or anything, but when I would inhale going down there, like a tuft of skin would fold back into my mouth and tickle my uvula and almost choke me to death.
Good God. Yeah.
By the way, I tell you the solidarity face that Lou gave, I swear to you, when you said she fucked some other guys before, some of them black dudes. Lou was like, ain't it always how it goes? I mean, you see his face he made. He really made the, oh, Christ, man. Every one of these girls.
Trying not to be bitter.
What the fuck? What the fuck?
That's how every story ends.
What are you looking for? Do you need to find out where you bottom out? Yeah. Jesus Christ.
The one thing that you cannot compete with is Black Don.
It's true. Nicholas.
Love Guru's right. Nicholas.
Thank you for calling in, dude.
Wish I could conclude, but I guess we'll get another time.
No, I thought it was over. Go, stop. Conclude.
Sorry. Yeah, conclude. No, I'm so sorry.
Well, you know, that experience did not bother me one bit, because in my mind there is, you know, I don't know any better. So this is great. This is fantastic. And not to toot my own horn, but I think I did all right, man. She kept me around for 3 months before I got full of my own self and... You know, started to know what other chicks were.
That's what I did too. I did a similar thing.
I think the whole Black Dawn thing, like, you know, there's a lot of us out there that aren't too bad. You just gotta know how to watch that thing out, man.
That's his like, fucking. I love that. That's his like. That's as confident as white dick can get. Yeah. Some, you know, and there's a lot of black. That be some white dicks aren't so bad. Yeah. Not so bad. They can.
It's basically white dick is the methadone to black dick's heroin.
Yeah, I mean you're still gonna be itching, but you know it's gonna take the edge off a little bit.
You're definitely gonna be able to function.
Nicholas, thank you, buddy.
All right, y'all. Thanks. Absolutely. So much.
So you should be jumping up and down doing Hava Nagila Hava.
She's right. The love guru is always right, everyone. We'll be right back. It's the Bonfire.
And now back to the Bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
Dan Soder, you are simply the best.
Big J, you're the best. 50 episodes. They said we couldn't do it.
Campers.
We did it because of you.
Burnouts.
Counselors.
All of you.
Truck drivers. Blonde hooies.
Remember Jill from Long Island?
Oh, we miss you, Jill.
What
come
Christ
back.
What the happened to Jill from Long Island?
I hope you're not dead.
Well, I can't hear. Am I low? Do I sound like I'm low?
You need some snare in your headphones?
Maybe can I check my levels, Lou? How are my levels? Levels good?
I'm burping up a cake cookie. Jacob, did you poison us?
Never.
The fuck did you put in that cake? The cookie cake?
Jacob, why am I falling asleep?
Now you're all mine.
Now you'll learn.
Welcome to
Jacob's. Play by the rules.
Welcome to Jacob's show. Let's talk about your sex life.
I don't want to.
You got to learn how to play by the rules.
You never played by the rules. You didn't think there would be a cost and effect?
What?
We make Jacob sound like a character that if you say his name backwards, he vanishes.
Yeah, Boojica. Boojica.
Tatab. Bokaj.
Ah, the old Scandinavian lore. He is the bringer of mischief.
Jacob Butter. Just throwing cookie cake in the air.
Frosting!
Frosting for everyone.
From another dimension of fun!
Lou was saying yesterday.
You and Lou.
Both watched Grease. Not together, the way I hoped. But we separately watched it. Felt the same way, Lou. Didn't like Danny Zuko. Didn't connect to him at all.
He wasn't even trying to be Italian. Fucking Zuko.
Yeah, he wasn't trying to be Italian. And the thing is, you do Grease, you better just do Travolta.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like, do Travolta.
Wow. Okay.
If you do Christopher Walken on stage, just do Jay Moore's Christopher Walken.
Yes.
It's over. You're not going to get any better than that. And so...
Why did this guy try doing his own take?
Jacob,
can you bring up footage of Grease, the live Grease?
And, like, the problem is, what he ended up doing was, like, not as cool. Like...
Right.
Like
no personality.
Like their fucking... Like dance, their bleachers dance.
Yeah, which is great.
Yeah, he just didn't like have the right foot stuff movement and everything.
That's
he was trying to make it not John Travolta.
Yes, he would make a nice Disney prince.
Yeah, no, he's a very good looking guy in great shape. It was just it wasn't Danny Zuko. And I said before, and we were saying when they came in before, Kanicki was just a guy, like if I saw him today on the street, I would not know who that is. And I just saw him hours ago.
Oh, the guy that played Kinnick.
Just very nondescript people playing it. And then me and Christine were talking, watching it. And this is going to be, it's going to be an unpopular statement until you hear what I'm saying.
Okay.
Do you have to force feed several black people into something that is such an obviously white thing? Dude, me laughing so hard. And I won't say it on the air, obviously, because I don't want to offend anybody, because I'm just being funny. Like, scenes of that show, like, where they have like the black girl playing Mary Maraschino, and she's like in the principal's office. It's like, Mary Maraschino, why don't you bother? He goes, hey, get out of here, darky. What are you doing in my god?
They bring back the 50s.
Yeah, we're like, this is like 1950s high school. Like, it wouldn't be that cool.
This is the pinnacle of racism.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It was like, it's so, I mean, you made a face like I was saying they said that in the show. That was not in the play.
That would have been hilarious if they're like, you know, you have a different principal.
Yeah, that would have been an improv. That was my second thing. I didn't like Danny Zuko and all the blinding racism that was throughout it.
I mean, they really put a lot of hard...
No, but I'm saying, but it looks, for that reason, it comes off weird.
Yeah, because in original Grease, there was absolutely not one black person, right?
No, I don't think. And if there was, it was like very background or whatever. But it's just like they forced. And by the way, the black people used were great dancers and great singers. I get that. It's just not. Why do you need to inject?
So she's basically doing Olivia Newton. All right, so we got a clip up right now.
Oh, Juliana Huff, dude, is lights out hot.
She is so hot. Yeah.
Met a girl crazy for me.
You know it?
Yeah. She is. Wait, she's from Dancing with the Stars?
Yeah.
Yes.
First, I just felt gay for knowing this musical, and then I feel like you're gayer for knowing Dancing with the Stars.
Whoa.
Look.
I watch it with my man.
Look at his walk. He's not doing it.
Tell me more. Tell me more. Like, does he have a car?
I don't know. But did you fall into this, Lou? Here's what I will say about it. Did you fall into really enjoying, like, their celebration at the end?
Yeah.
I was very into that.
Yeah, here's the deal.
But they didn't do a good job with the, I got chills, they're multiplying.
They didn't hit that?
Because he's not, that's John Travolta.
Yeah.
They're multiplying.
Yeah.
Like, that's, you need his voice.
Yeah, you're right.
It's so weird.
It's so weird.
It's like, Sandy comes around, it's like, so weird.
Multiply.
I got chills, they're multiplying.
Oh,
it's so weird. Sandy.
I had a brain aneurysm. Zoltan turned off my brain aneurysm.
Hey, Sandy, I can't feel the left side of my face.
I think I'm dying.
Is that the stroke side or is that the heart attack side?
Just lay on top of me.
It feels very weird.
Yeah, that guy. Yeah. There it is.
Yeah, that's Travolta.
Yeah.
You know what? And I'm gonna give the credit where the credit's due. Vanessa Hudgens' father died the fucking day before, and she showed up, and I don't like the song she did. I don't like that Rizzo song, but she killed it, and she got a big standing ovation. That was very nice. Mm-hmm. She still showed up for this thing. I'm sure she had, they had to have had some sort of an understudy for these things.
Right, because it's live.
They have to. Like, what if just something terrible
happens?
So wait,
the guy that played Danny Zuko kind of looks, what's his real name, but he reminds me of like when you meet a handsome guy with no personality.
He's just
like, hi.
He's just nondescript. That's the problem with the whole T-Birds in this thing. They were all nondescript.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, just no one in this thing stuck out to you, except the girl. The Sandy girl was great.
The women and the whole, all the women.
Yeah, actually, all the girls. Yeah, the girls were actually all pretty great.
Anna Gasteyer as the principal, she did great.
Yeah, it was just like everything, like the... they also changed the story.
What?
Oh, yeah.
Of a few things. Do you know the movie?
Yeah, absolutely.
You don't like Grease, you said.
No, I love it. They used to put it on, it was a safe movie for daycare, for after school.
You know what's funny? And I bet I watched it very young, too. I was telling Christine this yesterday, too.
Yeah.
I didn't know the song, There Are Worse Things I Can Do, and Greased Lightning. I didn't know they were in the movie at all until I was a teenager, because the version I had was taped off a TV.
Yeah, that's what we
watched.
And
they cut both of those out. There's no Greased Lightning and no other better things.
I take this back. They showed us the tape because there was Greased Lightning when we saw it.
First of all, they showed it to a daycare. The song There Are Better Things I Can Do, I didn't not realize, is saying that, like, she's like, what am I supposed to do when I'm hanging out with a dude, like, not fuck him? I'm supposed to just, like, tease him and then leave?
Yeah. I'll tell you this. We did have a sexy-ass daycare. All the girls knew.
But that's the truth. Like, that song is all about saying, she's like, what should I do? Should I just, like, leave guys with, like, blue balls and split? Like, I'm cool.
The guy's name's Aaron Tebbit.
She goes, like, should I wait around for someone to love me or treat me right?
Was this it? Jacob.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There are worse things I could do.
I didn't know the song.
Than go with a boy or two. Even though the neighborhood thinks I'm trashy and no good.
But she does kill it, and her dad died hours before this.
True, but there are worse things I could do.
Listen to these words.
I could flirt.
I gotta use a bad word.
Make
them think.
Then refuse to see it through. That's a thing I'd never do.
Wow.
Stay home every night.
She's saying, what am I supposed to do? Not fucking suck everyone?
Yeah.
I'm not that guy. Wait around for Mr. Right.
I like how horned up she is as a character.
Yeah, she's worked up. Also, I didn't really get the concept. She doesn't know who she's pregnant by. Then suddenly she's not pregnant, so she's like, great news. I can go right back to fucking being a whorebag again.
Which is great.
And then Kanicki's like, don't be a whorebag, be my whorebag. And then Kanicki started doing fucking major opiates, and then I think he's in a wheelchair now or something, or he had an amazing recovery.
He's dead.
And then he died.
Yeah. And he's dead.
Yeah, he was in bad shape, amazing recovery, and then now he's dead. What a sad life. You know what it is? That's that syndrome of, like, he watched John Travolta go become a fucking major star, and then Kinnicky became like a Cinemax dude after Taxi. That was it. But you know what? If you just would have looked at the, I wish I could have drug counseled. I'm like, dude, you got to spend golden years with Tony fucking Danzer, dude.
Oh, a Taxi interview.
Younger Tony Danzer, when he was crushing hey, Jeff, you want to go out and get some pussy? It's me, Tony Danzer.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, we know that, Tony. We had to name your character Tony, like we do in every TV show.
Yeah, I don't remember things so well, you know? I want to look over when you call my name.
Okay, well, Tony, here's the deal. I don't like you as a person, but I've written you on the show, and you're a successful character.
Do you got Born to Hand Jive on there? They crush that.
This is Grease Lightning. Hold on.
Dramatic.
Yeah, Grease Lightning can suck it.
Whoa.
This car could be.
First of all, it's one of the mess up. Look. That was off the time, you see?
Dramatic. Yeah.
That was really funny.
Ultramatic. Why, it could be.
This is not one of
Grease Lightning!
Grease Lightning!
AC Slater. AC Slater plays Vince Fontaine. That's Kinnicky.
What?
Yeah.
What?
That fucking deli worker.
That guy looks like a med student.
And tell me it's not weird when all the black guys start showing up.
Well, in the original play, Kinnicky did this scene.
Yeah.
Travolta stole it for the movie because he could.
Good. Thank God. Oh, Lotus? That was the story change, too, they did. In this one, Kinnicky comes up. Yeah, they changed that out. Yeah, they changed the word tit and cream. The story change in this one is if you remember.
That's Kinnicky?
Yeah. If you remember.
I'm angry. I'm fired up.
If you remember Kinnicky, the big thing with Kinnicky was he asked Zuko to be a second at Thunder Road. And then he drops a penny, goes to pick it up, and a door accidentally hits him in the head.
Ooh.
And he gets conked out. Yeah. In the play, in this one, they make him puss out. He basically says to Zuko, he goes, oh, I might have a kid on the way, you know, I don't know. And he basically says, I'm scared. So Danny Zuko like fakes whacking him on the head and gives him a wink, and he was like, oh, I guess I'll have to do it for you.
Boo. Oh, okay.
Boo is right.
Boo.
Jacob, do you have the hand jive?
Am I the only one in here that likes Grease 2 better? I like motorcycles and Michelle Pfeiffer.
You need a cool rider.
Cool rider, dude.
Yeah.
That's a great tune, though. I need a cool rider.
Jacob, get off of our fan porn. Stop looking at porn of our fans. Our campers.
Is that your fucking... Is that your wallpaper now?
Just the top
just
of our
Leslie
head.
Swallowing bone?
Swallowing bone. Welcome to Swallowing Bane.
Bane?
It's Bane's there.
You guys in the band?
You guys are welcoming to Swallowing Bane.
We don't do now. We want to hear Cool Rider. Forget Grease from last night.
Is it because I brought up G2?
Murkface says he hasn't seen either Grease.
What?
What happened to you?
He's just watched Sylvester Stallone and Antonio Banderas and Assassins.
As gingery as you are, your parents didn't keep you in the shade all the time watching movies?
They didn't. You've never seen Grease.
I've seen bits and pieces, but I've never seen the whole thing from start to finish.
I bet you saw Orphan Annie, you racist motherfucker. You like freckles and red hair.
I did see Orphan Annie.
I bet you boycotted and picketed the Black Annie.
Didn't see that one.
You see, I'm okay. By the way, I'm sure it was a wretched film, but I'm okay with Black Annie being modern. Do you know what I mean? Taking place in today. I didn't have any problem with that at all.
Yeah.
It's weird to see black people playing white characters in a thing set in the 50s.
What about that white guy that got cast as Michael Jackson?
I mean, I don't have much emotion. I don't have like a racial thing about it. I mean, he looked pretty white by the time he died. I almost blame Michael Jackson for that. If he stayed black looking, that really wouldn't be even a possibility to do that. I don't think they're going to overly do like crazy makeup on this. I mean, they're going to obviously do like prosthetics makeup and stuff, but they're not going to. I think they got him probably mostly for his fucking tone and like angles of his face.
Yeah.
At this point.
So that is, I think that is MJ's face.
I mean, no one's going to hire like the fucking, the 2 and a Half Men kid to play young Michael Jackson. It's going to have to be a black kid.
Yeah.
Right?
Yes, I think so. I'm not casting the movie.
Now but, wound up.
I know you are. We should, you know what? Hey, real quick, hit some Kenny Rogers and let's calm this motherfucker down.
Can we take Kenny Rogers, take it to the break, and then can we come back and then watch our goddamn... We started saying we were going to watch this video. Oh, hang on.
It's just a promo. I can't find the song.
America's favorite musical.
Oh, yeah.
Can you go? How low can you go?
Today's hottest stars.
You
go?
Do you love Grease, Lou?
I was raised on Grease.
You love it?
I watched it as I was a little kid. I always used to wear leather jackets like Danny Zuko.
They tried at the end, and they also left out the dance, the belt buckle dance, and you're the one that I want when they come in the steps. But then they did it when they came out at the end to take their bow. They just started doing it a little bit. But it's just not like they did. Listen, all kudos, a round of applause, I'll say, for the production. It was fucking amazing what they did. Like what they did, getting these guys flying all over the place. I mean, they show them backstage, like they to jump on golf carts and go like, you know, down the road to another set for another scene. Like it was all in real time. It was
good.
Live. It was amazing.
Really?
It was live.
Hmm. I'm a little upset that I missed it.
You should have DVR'd it, buddy. It was great. Very few mistakes. I guess the East Coast feed I heard had something. Oh, thank you. Whew, that's better. Oh, yeah. Stop it. I'm going to get mad again because watch this guy not Danny Zuko it.
Stir.
She kills it. She's so hot.
I got chills.
Oh.
They're multiplying. And I'm losing control. Cause the power you're supplying, it's electrifying.
No.
It's too musical theatery. And I love that movie. I love it. Sha-na-na's in it, man. That was my first concert ever. Sha-na-na. My mom wanted to fuck Chico from Sha-na-na.
Did she?
Can you bring up Chico from Sha-na-na? My mom wanted to fuck him.
Could that have been your stepdad?
There was a shot. My mom was single at the time when she took me to see Sha-na-na. I'm pretty sure she
was. Do you think she was waiting around like to meet Chico? Be like, my son wants to meet Chico.
My more upsetting thing is I wonder if that's how she got tickets. Do you think she fucked Chico for tickets?
Get your mom on the horn.
Let's see Chico.
Old Dave Chico Ryan.
Oh, yeah. She wanted a shot at Chico. If I was picking a stepfather, I would have went with Bowser.
Bowser.
Yeah. That's the guy.
That's my style.
We have a job. That's to introduce commercials. So what do you say we take our last break? Then we'll come back. And we'll find out about this badass motherfucker who's about to fucking teach Ghostface Killer a lesson in gangsta.
Bonfire.
And now back to the Bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
Come on! Let's celebrate.
Celebration.
Party going on right here.
It's the 50th anniversary of the Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. I'm Dan Soder. That's Big J. Oakerson. You are
your partner too.
You are all campers.
We gon' celebrate. And burnouts. And counselors.
Whatever.
We're doing it right. I'm in a singing mood now watching that video. Me and Lewis, Christine's going to be putting that out from the...
Legion of Skanks?
At the Bonfire SXM. She's going to tweet it out from the Legion of Skanks. Me and... you want to give him a taste? One little piece? You just want to give him just the first couple lines?
It's from Jay's podcast, Legion of Skanks. Him and Lewis J. Gomez singing... You're the one that I want.
But what Christine's going to tweet out to you guys is the YouTube link where they actually splice together the video from the movie.
Which, by the way, makes it 1,000 times better.
Yeah. Especially because it looks like it's just going to be the video.
Yeah, I thought we were watching it.
I got chills.
Oh, is that Danny Zuko?
Yes. You got to admit.
Is that Jay Zuko?
It's not bad.
Is that big Danny Zuko?
Supplying.
Oh.
It's electrifying.
And then here comes the Puerto Rican rattlesnake.
Better shape up. Because I need a man.
Oh, you see the room cackle?
and my heart is set on you.
So check out that video.
Go check that out.
We'll be tweeting it out at the Bonfire SXM on Twitter. We got to talk about this guy real quick because I never watched the video.
I've almost ducked this guy in the news completely. I just know some nerdy, very wealthy guy scooped up the Wu-Tang Clan, the rights to their newest album.
Well, this guy's got a little bit of a background. He's the one that raised the price of that pharmaceutical.
Right.
The AIDS drug. $8 to $750 a pill.
Yeah, he's a real piece of shit.
From $8 to $750?
Yeah.
And then he went on.
Per pill.
And then people shamed him online, and then he said he was going to change it, and I don't think he ever did. And then
he never changed it?
I don't believe he did.
And then he went and bought at a private auction. Wu-Tang was releasing Enter Shaolin. I believe it was called Enter Shaolin.
Right.
Newest album. No one's heard it. This one guy bought it.
Why was it being sold at an auction?
I don't know.
Like, how does that happen?
I don't know, but they sold it at an auction.
$2 million.
$2 million. And then Martin Shkreli, what's his name?
Martin Shkreli.
What's it?
Shkreli.
And by the way, I love Wu-Tang. You love Wu-Tang. We know that. We just did Wu-Tang Wednesday last week. My thing is, why would you buy Wu-Tang's new album? Like, if you bought the rights to Enter the Shaolin, that's a great idea.
Yeah, but I think he...
Or Enter the 36 Chambers, I'm sorry.
But I think he's got a lot of money, so he just spent it. But now Ghostface was talking shit about him. But by the way, if you don't know this, if you haven't read this online, do yourself a favor and go read Ghostface Killah's 10 weakest rappers in the game. He puts it out, softest rappers in the game. It's a list he puts out every year, and it is fucking hilarious.
Does he do a video talk?
No,
he just writes it.
He just writes it, and he always shits on Drake, who he calls Aubrey.
Is that his name from?
Yeah, that's his real name. That's his legal name.
Aubrey?
Yeah, it's Aubrey.
So really?
Ghostface calls him Aubrey. But he had one of my favorite ones.
Well, what's Ghostface? Name isn't Ghostface. It's a little bit on the kettle black.
That's the video we're going to get into. But his list of softest dudes in the game, one of my favorite things is, I forget who he was talking about, but he said his flows are softer than dandelions in an open field. And it just really made me laugh.
Since we are, he said Lupe Fiasco. Is Miley Cyrus one of them?
No, he goes through...
That's Miley Cyrus.
Yeah. But he goes through and basically just talks about people that are disrespecting the game of hip-hop. And he's great. But he said that this Martin kid had the Michael Jackson nose. So go to a picture.
About the new guy.
Yeah, the guy that bought the album.
Ghostface has responded back to this.
No, that's
video.
Just what he said. And then this kid released this video that we're about to watch.
Does he say it in... A video, or is that written also? Ghostface have a video?
Ghostface calls him a piece of shit or something.
Yeah, Ghostface
in a video?
I believe so, yeah.
Yeah.
Let's find that first. Let's get the chronology here. I know we only have a few minutes here. Oh, there's my mom's boyfriend, Chico, from...
Boom, 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 boom. Jay, go to bed. Go to bed. Jay, go to bed.
Banging your mom.
Getting your mom's tits. Come see your mom.
Fuck your mom.
Gotta see your mom's bits.
Pump, 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 jizz, 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 get a job.
Got a job. But, da, da,
Ghostface.
Yep.
The G-Face Killer.
Ghostface
Killer. Ghost and Killer, I gotta ask you guys, man. You guys know that guy bought you guys this $2 million, your CD for $2 million at the auction.
Yeah, that shithead. Shithead brought it. You know what I mean? Yeah.
Martin Shkreli.
Yeah, nah, he's like this, nah, because you know... You don't take some AIDS pill that you have for, I guess, what, $7 and then make it like $800.
Yeah, that's what
you know
he
what
did.
I mean? You don't do that like that. I don't care if you brought the Wu-Tang, whatever.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean? But on that note, that's why, you know,
You don't like that?
Crazy.
You don't like Martin?
I don't even know him.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But when I heard what he did with the AIDS like that,
medication.
That's not right. It's not right. $7 to like $800?
Yeah, that's not cool.
A pill?
Are you cool with Martin Shkreli keeping the CD, or would you like
that's
him to...
His name?
I mean, right now, that's... Yeah. It's out of my hands, man. You know what I mean? It's whatever. I don't know about it.
That's good. Now, I want to hear this nerd's response. Is he serious, by the way?
Dennis, I'm going to call you by your government name. You're not a Ghostface Killer. I'm sorry. In fact, you know, most people don't ever try to beef with me. Do you know why? What do you guys think? Nobody's that dumb. Every one of my enemies, they try to stay anonymous. They try to stay out because, you know, it's just one of these things where, for whatever reason, you think it's okay to beef with me.
But that's a big mistake. You know, at the end of the day, I'm very sorry for you. You're an old man. You're an old man that's lost his relevance, and you're trying to reclaim the spotlight from my spotlight. That's not going to work, Ghost. Dennis. In fact, I think that...
Fuck you, Dennis! This is you, Dennis!
Fuck you, Dennis!
Dennis, this is you!
I'm going to erase all your shit from this album.
Right here, man. Right here.
I'm going to erase you from the record books of rap. You're going to be done. You're my son. You have to listen to me. I butter your bread. You understand me?
You'll be a ghost for real, motherfucker.
Without you, without me, you're nothing. And so even though I pity you, I have to
pause that for a second. Isn't that a threat? Isn't that like a legal threat? Or you'll be a ghost for real, motherfucker?
I just pooped.
Yeah, but
really, I heard that through headphones.
Well, you gotta tell the audience that he's surrounded by like
just scared the shit out of Dan. Literally, is this how you treat us on our 50th show?
That's the only black guy. I think these are white guys.
Probably, he was only able to.
Well, he's also cutting a shitty wrestling promo. That's all this is. Keep playing it.
I'm not gonna let this slide. I expect you to write me a written apology from the heart. Some contrition, some long letter where you explain your sorrow and sadness for what you've done.
This is not a friend's neither, motherfucker.
That guy's white.
And you know, you're the only tough guy from New York City. I'm sorry, but you don't know us. We saw your boy kill a priest. We saw him getting pitched for what was it, 10 kilos of cocaine?
Like
some of that China white. And what did he do, Tana?
He's copping pleas like a little bitch to the police. He ain't even got no damn year sentence to his ass.
Yeah.
Copping pleas. I got kids.
I've got kids.
We all got kids out this motherfucker.
And you're crying to the Jake right away. Why is that? Why are your goons not as hard as mine?
Lift up your skirt, motherfucker.
Yeah, well, look.
Why are your goons not as hard as my goons?
Dude, I'd love to catch this guy in the six train. He just gets caught by some dude.
Don't ever mention my name again. Or it'll be... There'll be more of a price to pay than just this video.
This video's not even a price to pay, you fucking turd.
Yeah, you really hate that guy.
I see. He's such a little bitch.
He says everything he does is real.
He doesn't do shit.
Why is he a gazillionaire? All money left to him?
Well, he did like stock market. He's like he's like one of those autistic kids that's good with numbers. He's Rain Man.
But he's going to jail.
No, he's not. He's fucking rich enough. He'll get out of it.
What's he going to jail for?
Jacob?
Gotta be sleep.
Tax shit, right? Or something?
Illegal trading.
He did illegal trading. He almost did he's paying investors off illegally through other companies.
Oh, no.
Those
goons.
By the way, watch Billions on Showtime. It's awesome.
Oh, cool. Yeah, check it out. Hey, by the way, this Sunday is a Billions takeover, a Bonfire takeover. Bonfire takeover of Billions, episode 4, this Sunday at 10 p.m. Make sure you check out Showtime, watch Billions to see Big J and myself.
Lou, did you see me in the trailer for next week?
I did not.
He says Purple Nurple. You can hear it.
Purple Urkel.
Purple Urkel.
I remember the line. I'm method.
You are. You live it. You live it. Campers, thank you so much for having us do 50 shows. Hopefully we do another
gazillion. I hope it's gazillions.
Oh, that's gazillions.
It's a real number.
At the Bonfire SXM on Twitter. At the Bonfire SXM on Instagram. The Bonfire at SiriusXM.com to send all of the nude photos for Jay and myself.
More tasteful stuff.
I get the tasteful stuff. I get all of it.
At Dan Soder.
On Twitter. At Big J Oakerson on Twitter. You guys are the best, and we have the best crew.
Any shows, buddy? Come this. You're on.
I'm in Arlington at the end of this month.
No, I'm in Webster, New York, this Thursday, Friday, Saturday.
The Comedy Club.
Go
out to
Comedy Club. Yeah,
it's a fun club.
Great. I've never been there. It's my first time there. I just got back from Albany. Albany was unfucking believable. I told you, everybody came out. A lot of Bonfire fans. It was a lot of fun. I'm excited for this week in Webster.
And thank you to all the fans that came out in Providence at the Comedy Connection. You guys had a fucking great weekend.
It's a fun ride, and we're excited to keep taking it with you guys.
We love you guys, and we'll see you Wednesday at 6. Bye.
Crackle, crackle.